called prison ball for grades 4 to 8, you'll need foam balls. So here we see the gym divided into two halves, and you're going to have to use some end lines to create some prison areas, or some zones for the prisons. You'll have one team on one half, and against the other team on the other half, and here we see the corresponding prisons. This is a dodgeball type game, so you're using those foam balls, so you can throw those in here, and we'll see how this game works. Now, if you don't want to do throwing as a regular dodgeball, you can always go rolling at the feet of the opponent, so it's a team dodgeball game, one team versus the other. And it's a very, very simple idea. What happens is if a player gets hit, so here we see a purple has thrown it and hit the yellow player, then that yellow player has to go to the purple side, and they're stuck in the prison on purple side. They're not out of the game, because what happens when they're in the prison, if they can get a ball and they can throw the ball and successfully hit one of those players from purple, then that player from purple goes to the yellow side prison, and the person who threw it gets to go back. So they save themselves, they get to go back to their team. And that's the basic idea. Here we see yellow has thrown it and hit another purple player, so that player goes into the prison. And again, yellow player is thrown it and hit another purple player, so that player will then travel into the prison. So anyone who gets hit gets to go in, has to go into the prison. And of course, as the balls roll there, they can grab them and try and throw them back to save themselves. A round is over when all the players are stuck in a prison, and then you can do a new round. And that's it. That's the basic idea for this game. It's a great way to have an extra tactic for dodgeball, where players have to be aware of their whole surroundings, not just what's in front of them, but what's behind them as well, as the balls go back and forth. King's Cone for grades 4 to 8, you'll need cones and foam balls. Different colors would be great, and thank you to Don Smith for this game idea. So to start, you'll split the playing area into two halves, two teams on each half. They have to stay on their half, and it is a dodgeball game. I love dodgeball games, so here's another one. Thank you, Don. And you also have three cones. Those are King's Cones on each side, and there will be targets. And if you have basketball nets, you can use those nets as well for another way to win the round, and I'll explain all the different ways. So you put the dodgeballs in, and you can designate certain colors for different things. I'll talk about that in a sec. But one way that you can win this round is if a team knocks over the other team's cones. So for example, blue team would lose that round, and you start a new round. Another way that you can win a round is if you would score in the opposing team's basketball net with a certain color ball. So the purple ball, it was thrown, that was the special ball, and right in the hoop, so the green team would win that round as well. And the third way to win is if you would eliminate all the other team, the members of the other team, by getting them out with a dodgeball, so hitting them with a dodgeball. And some of the rules that we use is, so if you get hit, you'll go off to the side. So a player would go off to the side if they're hit into the jail by the teacher. And so we see another player also got hit. So there's players who are out and they stay in a line. And they have to remember the order they were out, because if a player catches a ball, so another ball was thrown and a player caught that ball, then the first player who was out gets to go in. So every time a ball is caught, a player gets to go back in. If a player can shoot a ball into a hoop, then they can save everybody who is in the jail. So that ball was in the hoop, so everyone who was in the jail would be free. And obviously, if a whole team is eliminated, then that round would be over. So in this case, the blue team would win. Hideout for grades 2 to 8, you'll need 4 mats, foam balls, and cones. And thanks to Justin for this game idea. So in Hideout, you're going to use the center circle, and you'll place down some cones around the circle. That will be the throwing pit. And you'll place down 4 mats on the sides of the gym, and those mats have to stand upright on their ends. And you'll place down the foam balls in the middle circle, and have one student who will start as a thrower inside that circle, and that thrower must throw from inside the circle. And the rest of the players will stand somewhere around the perimeter of the mats, and they'll go in the same direction. So you'll have to choose a direction that they'll travel through. They'll be running around in that direction. And they will be able to stop and hide behind the mats for 10 seconds if they'd like, but no longer than that. And then they'd have to move to the next mat. They can't go backwards. So when the game starts, you can imagine that the players are all running around, traveling around in that direction. And if a ball is thrown and it connects with the player below the waist, then that player has to join the thrower in the middle. And so now we have an extra thrower. And that's basically the idea. So the game continues on, and as players get hit below the waist, then they join the thrower in the middle. And you just go on and on until a certain time, or until all the players have been hit. Battle Ball for grades K to 8, and you'll need 4 foam balls. And this game comes from Australia. And thanks to Sean for this game idea. So to start, you're going to need a court, and you're going to split that court into thirds, and one team, Team A, will be on one third, and Team B will be on another third, and the middle third is actually going to be a shared third, so the students from both teams can use that area. Now Team B will go in the space just outside of the court on Team A's side when the players are out. And they're actually not ever out in this game completely, so don't think of it as an elimination type thing. And Team A will of course go on the other side outside of the court from Team B's side when they're out. So here's just a look at what it might look like when you're playing. 30 on 30 is the max that you'll want to go, go. You can have 15 on 15 or 10 on 10, but 30 on 30 is kind of the official battle ball game. You're going to have a referee, and you're going to also have two other refs as the sideline referees. So a head referee who watches the majority of the game, and then the sideline referees who also take a look at some of the things. And all the battle ball official rules will be posted on the website, as well as if you contact Sean, and I'll put his email information at the end of the video. And so we have two dodgeballs to start. So it's a dodgeball type game, and there will be two to start and more added as the game goes on. Now, before the game starts, we're going to look at some of the values, and you can read this yourself. This is posted again in the manual, as well as a lot of other rules to do with sportsmanships for the players and the fans and the coaches and that kind of thing. So it's very important to take some time when you're going over this game to talk about all the values and the rules and the sportsmanship, because that's a number one rule for this game. And some of the rules for the battle ball we'll take a look at now is the game duration. So the game will take 10 minutes. So you have a 10-minute timer, or if one of the teams is out. So if a team is completely out, then the game will be over. And after 7 minutes, you can add the third ball, and at 9 minutes, you'll add a fourth ball. So these are all taken from the official rules. There's also a rule called the order off rule, where the referees will send players out, and there's different reasons the refs can automatically send players out, for foul language, rough play, breaking the rules, those kinds of things, unsportsmanlike behavior. And there's something called a ball-in rule, so that the teams must, or one team will roll the ball to the other team, kind of giving them possession, if the team has had the ball for longer than 5 seconds, because there's a rule where teams can only have the ball for 5 seconds, or if the ball is just sitting there too long on one team side, and the ref decides that the team must give it up to the other team. So this is again, it's a dodgeball type game with these rules put in place. Now, some of the rules about when players are out. So if a player is out in this game, if they are hit shoulders down, so if a ball gets them anywhere shoulders down, then they are out. And remember, they're not completely out, but what they'll do is they'll go to that area opposite from their side, outside of the boundary line by the other team. If a player throws a headshot, so if one team is throwing too high and they hit somebody else in the head, then that team or that player who threw it is out. Also, if a player is throwing at a really close range or unnecessarily hard, so if they're chucking it at a player in an unsportsmanlike way, then that player can they'll be called out by the referee. If a player steps out of bounds or onto the other team's area, that's also out. If a player fumbles a thrown ball, if a player kicks a ball, or if a player disobeys the ref, so those are some of the main rules how a player is out. And of course, you can adjust these for a school purpose if you'd like, but I really do suggest taking a look at the actual official rules and put everything into play. And it sounds like a really awesome game to try out. I've personally never tried it out yet, but I'd like to take a look at it and see if I can manage it with one of my classes. A player is not out when a player is hit by a ball thrown by own team. So the friendly fire stuff, that doesn't matter. If you get hit by your own team, you're not out. If a player catches the ball that's thrown at them, so someone throws a ball and they catch it, then they're not out. If a player is hit in the head, they're not out, but actually the player that threw the ball, as we saw before, would be out. If a player fumbles or juggles the ball but doesn't let it hit the ground, then they're not out. So they can juggle it, and as long as they catch it before it hits the ground. Or if a player is hit by a ball but the thrower had crossed the line, so if the thrower is crossing over the line that they shouldn't, when the player gets hit, they're not out. So those are some of the rules. Again, you can look at the official manual at the end. So here's just a little animation. We see a green player had got hit, so that player would then leave the court and then go to the opposite side. And from there, the player can still play the game. And if a ball gets to that player, they can try and throw it at one of the orange players to get them out. So they're never out. They're never technically officially out completely. So we see an orange player there got hit, and same thing. So they would go there. And once all players are along one of those edges, the game's over, or the 10-minute mark.
A boomerang for grades 1 to 6, you'll need foam balls. So in this game, students will be around the gym, and you're going to throw in the foam balls. And the idea is that students will go around and try and grab a ball and throw it at another player and try and hit them knee down. So anywhere knee down on the foot, or they can throw it, they can roll it, whatever, to try and get other players out. They can't tag them with the ball, though. And so if we see a player's got to the ball, they've brought it closer, they can throw it and get somebody in the leg, that player must sit down where they got hit. And same thing over here, someone's thrown it and connected another player on the leg or rolled it, whatever, and that player is down. And the way that those players can get back up is if a ball rolls to them, not the ball that hit them, so that ball has to be pushed away, but if a different ball can roll to them and they grab it, then they're back up and they can start running around again. Same thing here, a ball has rolled and they've gotten it and they can go back up. Sometimes kids share them with each other, so that's a good teaching moment there. And basically, if they have a ball in their hand and they get hit, they still have to sit down, but they have to give up the ball they just had.
This is castle ball. You're going to need dodgeballs and hula hoops. So in this game, you're going to create two teams, and before the game actually starts, you're going to have students work together to create some castles using hula hoops. And it's a bit tricky, but they can figure it out. They'll use one as a base and four for the sides, and then one to top it off to hold it together. And once they can figure that out and they've had some practice building them, then you can start the game. So you're going to throw a bunch of dodgeballs in. Now the goal of the game is to knock over the other team's castles, and every time a team can do that, they get a point. So if the blue team here, as we see, is throwing the ball and knocked over the castle, then blue team gets a point, and the orange players can go and rebuild that castle. While they're rebuilding the castle, blue team is not able to throw it at the castle being built. They can continue throwing it at the other castle. Now players can go around and block their castles, but if they knock it over on their own, then it's down and they can't pick it up.
Swamp ball, and all you need are two mats and a set of dodgeballs.
So in come our mats. You lay them flat on the ground on each half of the gym, and you will have one team on that half, one team on that half, like you would in any typical dodgeball game. And there are dodgeballs. Now, in this dodgeball game, if you get hit by a ball, you have to go onto the other team's mat, into their swamp. I think I have a little diagram here. So red threw to yellow, yellow got hit, he goes into the swamp on the other side. Okay, so say a yellow guy throws, hits a red guy. The red guy has to go across into the swamp on the other side. Okay, yellow hits another red, red into the swamp. Now, the way you get out of the swamp is someone on your team has to throw a ball over and you have to catch it while you're in the swamp. All right, so if it bounces and you catch it, it doesn't count. They've got to throw it over and you've got to have a good catch. So a red guy throws it and one of his teammates catches it on the mat, so he gets to go across and back onto his side. The game ends if you can get all the other team onto your swamp or in your swamp. It's called Castle Pool for grades 4 to 8. You'll need foam balls, hula hoops, and plastic bowling pins. And thanks to Aaron Parsons for this game idea. It's actually a variation of the castle ball game. So to start, you'll have the gym split into two halves, two teams, one on each side, and you'll place down 7 pins for each team somewhere within the volleyball court. And then each team will also build a castle using hula hoops, so one at the bottom for the base, 4 sides, and then one to cap it off on the top. And the pins will represent the pool balls, say 1 to 7, and then the castles are pool ball, the 8 ball. And then you'll have the players in there. You can have one player max guarding a pin, so you can't have more than one player per pin guarding. And then you'll put the foam balls in and they'll start playing. The goal is to knock over the other team's pins before their 8 ball, so before the castle. So as they're throwing the balls around, they're trying to knock over the pins. They could also roll, or you can have kicking if you'd like, depending what skill you're working on. So they need to knock down all the pins first, and then they can go and try and attack that castle or knock that castle down and to win the round. Now, if a team, just like in a round of pool, if you knock over the castle or the 8 ball before the pins, then you would automatically lose the round. It's called Walk the Plank, and the kids absolutely love this game. One of the kids said it was his favorite new game. This is for grades 5 to 8. You'll need 2 mats, 2 benches, 2 hula hoops, and dodgeballs. I also put a disclaimer here that if you don't like dodgeball games, then just don't play this game. Or if you thought about it, this game could actually be modified to be a tag game instead. So that's up to you. I'll leave that up to you if you want to think about it. I'm not going to give away how to make this a tag game. So here's the lines that you're going to use. You're going to use a center line and some end lines. You're going to place down benches. Those benches are going to be the planks that the students will have to walk down, like on a ship. You know, they walk and then they jump into water. Well, instead of water, we're going to use the mats, some exercise mats that they're going to jump onto. Then you're going to place down some hula hoops. Now, those are going to be some throwing areas. So you can place poly spots if you don't have hula hoops or whatever, if you want to use those instead, but talk about that in a second. And then you'll have your players, so one team against the other on each on their own half of the gym, and use whatever dodgeball rules you normally use. So you can you throw in the dodgeballs here, and you can have it where, you know, waist down or shoulders down, or, you know, if you catch a ball that's thrown at you, then the person who threw it has to go to the other side. So we'll look at the specific rules for Walk the Plank, though. So what happens in this game, we'll see that the game's going, and a yellow player got hit. So that yellow player will then go to the opposite side, over on the green team side, into that zone on the end, and the first player hit from each team will actually become a thrower. So they'll go into the hula hoop and in the throwing zone, but of course they'll want a ball. So, well, there's one right there. If there wasn't a ball nearby, they have to wait until a ball rolls into that zone. They can't go into the area where those green players are. That yellow player waits, and of course the balls will roll there anyways, it's not a problem. And meanwhile, as that player was waiting as a thrower, then somebody else from the yellow team got hit, and they are now going to walk the plank. So that second player, or third, or fourth, or whatever, they'll be the walkers down the plank. So we see the player walking. Now at this point, when the player's at the end, they're going to make a jump at the same time the thrower's going to throw the ball, and see if they can catch it before landing, or on landing. And that's the part that the kids had a lot of fun doing, so the walking the plank and trying that jump and catching it. So it's good communication. Now that was a successful catch. So what happens is the thrower, who was there the longest, gets to go back to their team. They're saved. And then the game continues. Well, the game, of course, is always continuing on. The person who caught it is then a thrower. They have to be a thrower before they can go back. Of course, meanwhile, the game would continue on, and usually there's players that are getting hit and going to the plank. So there's always going to be a thrower and always people that are walking the plank, and it would continue on like that. So that's basically the idea. Now, we're going to fast forward a little bit. So later on in the game, we see that the yellow team isn't doing so good. They have a lot of players on the plank, and what's been happening is the thrower's been trying to throw the ball, and as they catch it, well, they're not quite successful. So anytime that happens, if they've jumped and missed, then the player who jumped has to go to the back of the plank, and the thrower has to keep trying to throw. Now, of course, if it's really not working well for you, then you can switch things up. We saw, meanwhile, the yellow player, the last one, got hit. And so that player then goes to the plank, and there's nobody left on the yellow team, so the round would end, and you would start a new round. But sometimes the rounds could just go on, and that's the great part, is always back and forth. And like I said, the kids had a lot of fun doing this.
The only thing is just be careful. Tell them to be careful on the bench. If there's only two people on the bench, maybe there can be the one sitting on the one end so it doesn't fall or anything like that. Of course, that depends on the quality of bench you have. Ultimate Warriors. The original idea comes from Joe DeFritis. So thank you, Joe. It's for grades 4 to 8. You'll need foam balls and cones. Now to start, you're going to split the playing area into three games, and there'll be three games of dodgeball going on. Farmers on the right side, the knights in the middle, and the warriors on the left side. And the idea is, in the time, or whatever time's given, is to advance yourself to become an ultimate warrior on the left side, and that'll depend on how well you play. And so there's three games that'll be going on simultaneously. We've got all the players in, doesn't matter where they start, you choose where they start. So there's the players going to face off in the dodgeball games, three of them going on at the same time. And simple rules is, well, whatever dodgeball rules you want, but the idea is if a player gets hit, so a thrower has hit a player in the middle game, the player who got hit needs to go drop down a rank to the farmers, and the player who hit that player gets to move up to the warriors. And so that's the basic idea. Now, if on the warrior side, if somebody gets hit, the player who got hit has to go down to drop a rank to the knights, but the player who threw it obviously can't advance any further. Same thing on the farmer's side. If somebody gets hit on the farmer's side, the person who got hit doesn't go anywhere, but the thrower gets to move up. And so you play for a determined amount of time, and you blow the whistle at the end. Anyone who's in the warrior side is the winner for that round. And so it's a great idea where players don't get eliminated and sit out for any time. It just goes on and on. Thank you, Joe DeFritis, for this awesome idea. Please hit subscribe for more games and visit physedgames.com.